You don't have to love me. You don't even have to like me. But you will respect me. You know why? 'Cause I'm a boss.
That is the theme song for all of us sisters. Be bossy. Hey, so after nearly 50 years of existence, I became the first Pinay to be the chair of the Asian American Studies Department at UC Davis. I think, but I'm not sure, probably, I might well be the very first Pinay to ever serve as a leader of a department in the entire UC Davis history of over 100 years. I even managed, with all the help of my students and the community, to create the first center focused on the Filipinx experience in the United States and the diaspora in the entire UC system, the Bulosan Center for Filipinx Studies. Okay, though, but I got a story for you. Y'all saw that Netflix series, The Chair. I will never, ever forget my very, 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 very first chairs meeting for the College of Letters and Sciences, where the Department of Asian American Studies sits. I'll never forget that first meeting with the dean. I was a little early, no Pinoy time that time. I was a little early, sat down at the big round table, and I just kind of noticed some of the other chairs looking at me kind of funny. I'm thinking to myself, oh shoot, did I wear too much makeup today? Is my lipstick too red? Am I looking just a little too cute? Did I mess up that balance of femininity that you're supposed to maintain, especially in white academic spaces? Because if your lipstick be a little bit too red and you just be a little bit too cute, somehow you can't be the intellectual and the leader they expect. So the dean comes in, and she's followed by a line of staffers. And then it dawns on me. The line of staffers that were following the dean into the office were all BIPOC folks, Black, Indigenous, people of color. One of them was Filipino. It dawned on me. My lipstick wasn't too red that day. It wasn't that I was looking a little too cute. It's because the only time they ever encounter a brown or Black woman or person was not at that table, but as staff. They expected that I was the administrative assistant, that's why they were looking at me sideways, who was going to pass out printed versions of the agenda, because they didn't expect me to be actually part of that agenda. Oh, God. That was like my worst nightmare come true. You know, early on in my career, I had this recurring nightmare. I would just wake up in a sweat. And in that recurring nightmare, these people come into my office, white folk, and they basically tell me, "We found an anomaly in your transcript. You fucked up on one of your classes in high school. We are now revoking your doctorate." Everything I had accomplished just disappeared in that moment. A recurring nightmare just kept haunting me for so much of my career. It just came true in that moment, in that chair's meeting. It's an experience so much of us have. An experience as Pinays, as women of color, that is so common. An experience that is common because we will always, very likely, be the one and only of us in the spaces where we may be dependent for our hustle, in institutions that were never, ever made for us. And y'all know what I'm talking about. What am I talking about? What do we feel? The imposter syndrome. I'm telling you here, sisters, I'm inviting you to reframe the imposter syndrome. I'm inviting you to claim the imposter syndrome. Why? I'm telling you that we can flip the script on the imposter syndrome. We could turn it upside down, append it. We can flip it. Y'all know what I mean by flip too? We're gonna add a Pinayista frame to the imposter syndrome. We are gonna draw on our culture, on our ancestral knowledge as Filipino people. We are going to build from a spirit of community, of sisterhood. We're gonna flip the script of the imposter syndrome. Now for me, what that means is this. I look into my own DNA. Some of you may wonder if you know, I don't have a lot of followers on IG. I call myself the Mad Professora. And the reason why is because my name is Robyn Magalit Rodriguez. Robyn Magalit Rodriguez. And if you know, and it's okay if you don't, but tell me, what does Magalit mean? Mad, to be angry. Well, let me tell you a story about that. Magalit is a name that was chosen by my great-great-great-grandfather, Damaso de los Reyes. Damaso de los Reyes, Damaso of the Kings. Well, Damaso, he was recruited by the Katipunan. He joined in the struggle to fight against the colonizers in the Philippines. And what he did is he took the name Magalit to be an imposter. He took the name of Magalit, where that was the name that his fellow kasamas, his fellow revolutionaries knew him as, Damaso Magalit. But to the Spanish, they knew him as Damaso de los Reyes, Damaso of the Kings. That's what de los Reyes means. So my great-great-great-grandfather adopted this name to be an imposter, where he escaped execution. He continued to go on and fight successfully towards the toppling of not just a colonizer, but an empire. He went on to live, to be able to then give me my life, my name, my purpose. And that's the lesson I want to share with all y'all today, sisters, is let's be the imposter. Let's be the imposter. How do we reframe our invisibility in the space of these patriarchal, homophobic, transphobic, white supremacist institutions that were never made for us? How do we reframe that invisibility and think of ourselves not as imposters, but as spies? Where we are in there taking the knowledge that we need to understand how they operate for our purposes. Be the renegade. Take those resources, apply them for the purpose they were never intended. I love this. Yeah, so be the spy. Y'all gotta be the spy. Be the renegade. And then be an organizer. You find your kin. You find them. You create your pods of safe spaces inside. You find them. You'll find them. Keep your roots in the community, because don't get it twisted. Don't get too seduced by the things that they say they're going to promise you. Never feel, ever, ever, ever feel like you belong in those places. But you find your space. And sisters, at some point in time, when you're ready, when you done your spying, when you been your renegade, when you done your organizing, and you ready, you come out here. We're waiting for you, Pinayistas. We are waiting for you. We are waiting. That's what I'm doing right now. That is, I've finally come to the place. I did my spying. I did the renegade. I organized. I'm done. I'm out. I'm going to come out here. There is no place at the table there, and that's okay. I don't want your table. And I'm doing the work now to build my own school. But my sisters, that's the invitation here today. We can reframe the imposter syndrome. We have a rich heritage, a rich culture. We have made it. We know exactly how to make it. We can and we will create the autonomous institutions of our own, rooted in our values of Bayanihan. Bayanihan, lifting as we climb, of Kapwa, that sense of spirit of community. That is our aim. That is our mission. And so with that, my sisters, be the imposter. That is the key. That is the key for our personal liberation and our collective liberation. Thank you.